took you from the ends of the earth, from its farthest corners, I called you. In verse 9, the Lord reminds us that he's taken us from the ugliest things that we were into. He snatched us right out of it, from the most gruesome places that we were in. He pulled us up out of it. Hallelujah. He went into the lowest part of our hearts and our minds, the filthiest places, and brought us up out of it. Anybody with me?
Amen.
From wherever you were and from whom you thought you were when you were doing what you were doing and saying what you were saying, God says in 9b, from those places I have called you.
Yeah.
And now that you've been called out, it seems like getting where you really want to be in life, in the spiritual realm, is hard. And getting where you want to be even in the natural realm is hard. Come on, he's giving you the prophecies of you being a millionaire and you getting money and you having all this stuff, but it seems like the closer you get to him, the farther away the promise is. But I've come to remind you today that God has not forgot. Hallelujah. Everything that he says he was going to do, I guarantee you, before you leave the side of heaven, you're going to see it happen. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. We quote that everything that we set our hands to, it prospers. But if you'll be real honest, you don't see the prosperity that we talk about. Oh, but it's really just a distraction.
Yes.
The devil has just put a wall up to cover what God really has for you behind your wall. Hallelujah. That wall is there to make you feel like God has forgotten about you. That wall is there to make you feel like God's not really on your side. Oh, but behind that wall is everything you've been praying for. It's everything you've been fasting for.
Yeah.
Behind that wall is everything that you've been asking God for. And the enemy is so weak. Hallelujah. And he's so ignorant and dumb and stupid. He doesn't even realize that the wall that he put up is not even really a wall. Oh my God. What it really is, my sister, is just a mirage.
Yes.
That's all it really is. Hallelujah. Anybody knows the definition of a mirage? Well, my dictionary tells me that a mirage is something that appears real.
Amen.
This is what the enemy has put up. A mirage is something that appears possible, but it's not in fact so. My dictionary tells me a mirage is an optical illusion.
Yes.
Caused by an atmospheric condition. Anybody got some conditions in your atmosphere that you really don't care for? Oh my God, it's just a mirage. My dictionary tells me that a mirage occurs when the light is bent. Hallelujah. After entering a lower layer of a hot air at an angle. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. So what the devil tries to do is he creates something that really does not exist.
Yes.
Come on, come on.
Amen.
He shows you the problem according to the fear that's stored in the back of your mind.
That's right.
Oh, come on, you were children. And you watched a scary movie, and then you get in your room and you hear a noise in the closet. It ain't nothing but a mirage.
That's it. That's right.
He paints a picture according to the fear that is in your